trust in you. Lord, I trust in you. I believe you're my healer. I believe you are.
Hi there. Welcome to I Believe in Miracles with Dave and Patty Loggy. And Dave happens to be out in the Carolinas today. He was there and then in Florida with Butch and Mike Politoski and Mike's son, little Mikey. And we also have Lila and Elizabeth in the studio with us. And then I think we'll have Mike on in a little bit and then Scott Whitley. So we have so many people, we won't know what to do with everybody. But I know everybody has testimonies from the Lord because God has been doing some amazing things. So we'll start out with you guys. Tell us what you've been doing and all the healings that you've had, salvations, people get filled with the Holy Spirit. And I know you had some people that just reconciled their relationships too, so that's cool. Oh, David Allen Loggy.
Quit messing around on the TV show. Well, I was at Walmart getting stuff ready to go tonight, and then we got invited to stay another day, and I had three people got healed of pain, arthritis over at the Dollar General. And then I went and met Butch over at the Walmart. And what did we get there?
Got four people healed there. There was a lady that come up to that was having some pain, and Dave went up to her, and her pain went away, and she started thanking us and thanking us and thanking us. She says, people just don't come up and do this for people, you know? it's not the normal thing, but it should be.
Amen. You know?
And there was a guy that Dave prayed for, and his pain left. And it's just one miracle right after another. You just hang around Dave, and it becomes normal. And until I come to Anki and learn this, you know, it was foreign to me. But now it's getting to be like, you know, I don't even say wow no more. You know, it's just
amen.
It's all wow. You know, I don't believe this. Wow. You know, but.
Being normal, that's a good thing.
That was just an hour's time, not even an hour's time while we were shopping. But everywhere we stopped, like when we went down to Florida, we had to drive nonstop 22 hours through the snowstorm that went and cut the nation apart. We'd stopped like at Hardee's, and four different people got healed before we got our cheeseburgers all ate. It's a way of life, and I'll let the other guys tell you some of the details of the story. I want to make it so it's so simple that saved, healed, and delivered is one word. All we're doing is flipping that switch and putting life into people.
Amen. Amen.
It's we were down in Miami. That was the one that asked us to come down, and he'd been not be able to walk without a walker in pain. He hardly ever got out of bed. And we got a video clip somewhere. I think Mike was supposed to upload them, and he got sidetracked today because of the TV studio here. His son got totally healed before we even got there. We walked in the door, and the presence of God just came in and just wrecked him.
Praise God.
And the relationship was, we didn't know the dad and the son hadn't been getting along at all, like not at all. And before we were done, they were hugging. And he had broken his shoulder or collarbone. He had no pain, and he got in an airplane and flew it to the Bahamas yet that day.
Wow. Praise God.
So the next time, send my passport, and I'd be in the Bahamas instead of North Carolina right now.
You wish, buddy.
It would have been a prolonged vacation.
So, what else happened at that meeting? It sounded like a lot of things happened at that meeting.
Well, the wife, she'd been to Kenneth Hagin. He graduated, Rhema graduated. And she wanted to move into prophetic. I said, oh, that's easy. Just pray for me. And I said, God's going to show you something. And she's seen a vision, spoke it. And I said, you can do that anytime you want. And she kind of like, what? I've never heard such a thing. I said, can't you speak in tongues whenever you want? Yeah. I said, what's that different from any other so-called gifts? So I had her pray over Butch and Mike, and Mike, it ain't really little Mike, it's the second Mike.
Oh, okay. Do they call him Mikey?
No.
No? Okay.
And Mike had to sit in the back seat with me, and he's got this phobia about people touching him, so he told me that right away. So I was really careful to make sure I touched him all the time.
Oh, Dave. Well, and you keep touching the desk that you're sitting on, and the computer wiggles every time you do.
Power of God shaking this place.
Oh, honey, you're funny.
Everywhere we've gone, we've trained them up. The first place we went, they didn't tell us we were going to go all the way across Florida the other way during the night. So we had to go to the East Coast from the West Coast on the way down.
Of Florida?
Yeah, everybody got healed, delivered, born again. The lady got filled with the Holy Ghost. The son, I'm guessing he's in his mid-20s, didn't believe any of this. He was kind of into some New Age stuff. And we had him pray for his dad, and his ears got opened while he was praying for his dad. And then he gave his heart to Jesus because he really seen the power of God real. And the mom got filled with the Holy Ghost. Her hands were so froze up and in pain, she couldn't move them. And she used to write Christian stories and stuff. She was wiggling her hand around and moving it.
She grew her husband's leg out.
Amen.
Didn't think she could do it, and Dave had her grow her husband's leg out. Or Mike had her grow her husband's leg out. And he was amazed by it. And then we showed the video to her son, and he just got wowed by it. You could tell the spirit was touching him. And then he ended up giving his heart to the Lord. And, you know, it was an amazing, amazing stuff.
So was anybody else healed there?
Well, everybody that was there. And in the entryway, when you walk in their house, they got a really nice big swimming pool inside in their entryway.
Wow.
Waterfall going into it.
And a screened-in roof.
Yeah, it's all inside.
Well, so cool.
I know you like to stay in Iowa, so you have to think about that. You could have a pool entryway.
Yes, honey, I should have switched you places this week.
I can sell the house and just move south.
Well, if God makes a way, we will.
We've everywhere we went, it's a good thing that you have to really think hard to remember all of them, because it's just a way of life. It's just flipping that switch where you know that you can get anybody's problem solved, because it ain't you doing it. It's the Jesus in you that gets the job done.
Right. Amen.
And the sad part is it's easier on the street. It's easier for people that haven't been a lot of church because they don't have any traditions to get rid of. They're in pain. Watch this. One of the ladies was 80-some years old at the Dollar Tree, and she was asking me for duct tape with designer duct tape. Why does an 80-some-year-old lady need designer duct tape? And she was on a treasure hunt for getting gift packs for the Boy Scouts. And all they had was pink designer duct tape. And I said, I'd get them the gray. Not designer. I said, I know the boys would not like designer pink duct tape.
You're probably right, honey.
I told her, I know I wouldn't want to get any of these designs in pink, would not fit me. It was kind of funny. That's how I found her, because she comes up and says, I know this is going to sound strange, but I need some help. What is designer duct tape? Well, that's that pink stuff down there with all them different stripes, checkers, polka dots, weird lines, hearts.
So did you get her healed?
What?
Did you get her healed of anything?
And yeah, her hands were all crippled up. She couldn't hardly hold the paper and stuff, and she's moving her hands with no pain.
Oh, praise God. So can you remember the other people in Walmart or Dollar Tree?
Well, there was a husband and wife that was in there, and the husband was walking with a cane, and Dave went up and asked him why he was walking with a cane. He says, well, he said, first he said he's old, and then he said that he'd hurt himself, so Dave asked if he could pray for him, and he prayed for him, and he asked him two or three times, he says, how does it feel? And like, he didn't believe that it was not working, and then his wife come over, and he prayed for his wife, too, and
they had no pain. They couldn't find their pain. They lost their pain.
Yeah, it was gone. Where'd it go?
Like, they're looking at their cane like, what am I going to do with this thing in my hand now that I don't have no pain?
Tell them to carry it sideways, huh, so they don't use it again.
Most of it was just people that were in pain. Somebody had a heart issue. Oh, that was at the restaurant. We had a waiter that really didn't believe in this, and we kind of picked on him. But all his symptoms left, and then Scott left him a really nice tip, so we really picked on him. He had to put it on the credit card ahead of time and tell him what his tip was going to be. I said, oh, we got to pick on you some more now. he was getting wowed with the first thing is, symptoms left, and he wanted to hear more testimonies. We showed him about a minute of LaDonna. I think that was what really convinced him.
Right.
The manager of the restaurant was sitting over there watching him, so he was afraid to spend too much time talking to us, you know?
Right.
Yeah, he was kind of not liking what we were doing. I can't think of what day of week it is anymore, let alone what all happened here. That
today's Monday.
I know, but how many days in a row we've been doing this, where we were at 4 or 5 days ago.
Well, you guys traveled from here to North Carolina first. Did you see any people healed on the way there?
I know we did, but I don't remember which one. It was really not a good trip as far as it snowed a lot. They had the road shut down. We had one time we couldn't, once you got around the wreck, nobody could make it up the hill because the hill was so icy. It was in the West Virginia part.
Uh-oh.
We declared over a lot of the people because, you know, we didn't have the ability to stop and get to them because of the police and traffic. And
so did you, when you first got to North Carolina, did you pray for anybody that was healed then?
We got here in, like, in the middle of the night.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, the lady at the desk, and the first on the way down, they asked us to go to a room, and the guy wasn't available, so we went over back to that hotel, and he didn't want any part of it. So I prayed over a card and handed him the prayer card. Then last night we got here, and I started reading, prophesying over a lady and telling her all kinds of things, and me and Butch prayed for her. Hopefully she's going to call you. I believe she's a single mom with 3 kids.
Yeah. Well, I'm sure she could use prayer then because it's not easy being a single mom with 3 kids.
She didn't say that, but that's what I've seen.
Oh, okay.
And she said, I really need that, so I'm really sure something wasn't going right. She just moved to town, working at a hotel desk. All the signs were there.
Yep.
It's so neat because we got to the Hardee's restaurant. Before we even got out of the car, there was a guy walking over the cane. And we kind of teamed up on him. He could get the pickup because we weren't going to let him get the pickup until he was totally healed. And he was having a hard time anyway, and all his symptoms left him. I'm trying to... Oh.
At the Golden Corral. There was 2 waitresses.
Yeah, we got down here. Pat took us out to the Golden Corral, and before we even got the bill paid, could you pay on the way in? A lady got her hips healed. She kind of shook and lined up, and then our waitress, she got healed and set free.
Oh, she had migraine headaches, and she's like, "Wow, it just gone."
Amen.
So Mike could probably give you more details on some of these, but these are some tough cases that they've been through healing ministries before that we got set free in a very short time.
Well, praise God. I know you don't give up easily. You just keep going after it and going after it till you get the job done.
No, I'll wait to pray. So what have you been doing?
Well, I can give you probably one of my favorite testimonies ever. This was so neat. God put me in the right place at the right time. I was out to lunch last Friday with my two daughters and my grandson, which, of course, I love doing that. Seeing my kids and my grandson, that's always a joy. And I got a text message, and I thought, well, you know, I read it quickly in case it was an emergency, but I didn't want to act like I'm ignoring it because my phone goes off quite a bit. And so I just read it briefly that there was a lady that Lila had gone and prayed for her baby previously, and I've never met her. I just kept hearing about hearing from her about different things. And so she texted me and she said her sister was in the hospital and she was in pain. And could I pray for her? And I said, I texted her back and I said, sure. I said, what hospital is she at? What's her name? What room number is she in? And such. And so I was going to the hospital and it's like, oh, I was over on the end where the maternity ward is. And then I get up to the floor and it's like, oh, this is the maternity floor. I always thought that was something wrong with the baby, or, you know, I didn't know what the whole story was. And so I knock on the door and they didn't answer. So I walked in and I'm like, hello. And there was a nurse. She turned around quickly and looked at me and she's like, excuse me, we're about to have a baby here. Can I help you? Like, she was really annoyed with me. And I said, well, I'm sorry. I said, I'm a minister, and your sister texted me, and she told me to come pray for you. She said you were in pain, and she said that she was going to tell you that I was coming. And so the nurse asked him if it was okay. So I went in, and I held her hand, and I was just ministering to her. And she just had a hold of my hand like a death grip, like she wasn't going to get let go of it. Because I'm thinking, am I supposed to stay? Am I supposed to leave? I just didn't really know exactly what to do. And so, but she wouldn't let go of my hand. So I thought, well, I guess I'll just stay for a while. I didn't know what they expected of me. And I didn't want to be in the way if they didn't want me there. I just felt like really uncomfortable. But I thought, well, I'll just stay here till they tell me to leave. Because after I got there, she was in real pain. They were trying to push it out really quickly. There was all kinds of doctors and nurses that had come in. And then the one nurse said, you know what? We don't have to push this baby out so hard. Let it be more natural. And so then the woman laid back and she relaxed. And they had given her some drugs that was to end towards labor that they really shouldn't have given her, I guess. And then, of course, I was praying for her. And so I don't know how much of it was of the drugs, how much of it was God. I don't have that answer, but I know God was there. So it kind of slowed down, and they all left the room, and she was very glad I was there. And then it kind of got more towards the end again. So the other nurses and the doctors came in. And she had a hard time pushing because she was just like wiped out. She had nothing left. And I was standing on one side, her husband standing on the other. And they said, pull on your legs with your hands. And she just looked at him like, are you kidding me? I'm just dead tired. So I said to the doctor, do you want me to help? He's like, yeah. I was like, okay. I felt really awkward, but it's like, well, if I'm here for a reason, I guess I'll do whatever I can. So I did. And, you know, I've had three children, but I've never been in the room when someone had a child. And so it was just really amazing. When that baby came out, I tell you, it was a miracle. And, you know, childbirth is always a miracle. And it just shows you how big God is. And that baby was just perfect and healthy. Of course, I was praying for the baby during the labor and praying for the mom. And it was just amazing. So I tell you, I was just on cloud nine. They're just not a whole lot better than that, seeing a child being born. But I guess we have to go to commercial. And then I'll tell you a little bit more when we come back. So hang on.
From the RE/MAX Real Estate Concept Studios, this is Webcast One Live.
I'm Brian Leach, owner of Service Legends, and my position is Chief Talent Officer.
I'm Nicholas Wunderscheid.
I am Bernie Homs.
And I'm the Service Manager.
Marketing Director and Client Relations Manager.
Everything that we do is about ensuring that we exceed your expectations.
Our clients are important to us, 100% satisfaction.
We're not just focused on heating and cooling. That's the easiest part of our job, actually, is fixing furnaces and air conditioners.
Everyone that we come in touch with, we want to improve lives.
Bottom line is, we've got our installation guarantees, 25% energy savings guarantee, comfort guarantee, temperature selection guarantee, property protection guarantee.
100% satisfaction guaranteed, fixed rate or it's free.
All of those guarantees are backed up with a 100% money back guarantee to hold ourselves accountable to making sure that you get what you're after.
Just fixing the problem today, if they have another problem 5 days down the road, it's still fixed rate or it's free.
We use what's called straightforward pricing. Our technicians are gonna give you an exact to the penny price on what it's gonna take before they move forward with any repair. That way you know what to expect.
It's the same price every day.
No surprises.
If you get off work at 5 o'clock in the afternoon, you come home, you realize that, oh, my furnace is broken. Now you need to call somebody out that night. You shouldn't have to pay more for that.
We're guaranteeing service 24/7.
We run afternoons, evenings, nights, weekends. We're staffed to work that.
Phone rings at 3 a.m. You'll get one of our representatives answering the phone every time.
We're not sending you out to Timbuktu in some call center. It's our Service Legend team members, our mission control team.
I'll take a call anytime.
And then they answer the phones same way during the day as they do at night.
It's a great day at your service company. How can we make you smile?
That's the only way to provide true 24-hour service.
When you're able to let somebody actually live in their home safely when they weren't able to do that before, where they don't have to stay up at night and worry about, is the heat gonna come back on? Are we gonna freeze the pipes? Is the baby in the room next door gonna be sick because they got too cold? When you're able to help somebody overcome challenges like that, that's impacting a life. That makes a difference. I get goosebumps thinking about it.
I love the team. I love the people that I work with.
We have fun, but we work hard.
I call them my ambassadors of legendary service. If you could just envision what that is, that's who we're sending to your home.
They literally will call in, pick up the phone and call and say, hey, I want to talk to your manager. And I get on the phone, they're like, that technician that was at my house was the greatest technician ever. That's cool to me.
We want to brighten people's days.
Every person that we have going into the house has gone through an extensive background check.
Drug testing, we have a very thorough interview process that 1 out of 140 people make it through.
If we promise you something, that's what you're going to get, no matter what.
We're here when you need us to protect the safety and comfort of your family.
If you're not happy, we're gonna make it right.
If we're willing to put 100% money back guarantee on what we do, what type of work do you think we do?
Give us a call. We're there for you 24/7, 365 days a year.
Enough said.
Hello, friends. I'm Mike Politoski, president of the Spiritual First Responders. Would you like to learn how to heal the sick, how to actually lay hands on the sick and see them recover? I've written a training manual called the Spiritual First Responders Training Manual, and I'd like to see you get a copy of it. For any donation made to hslm.us for $15 or more, we will send you one of these training manuals, and you can learn how to lay hands on the sick and see them recover just as Jesus did in the days when he walked the earth. Endorsed by Dave and Patty, it's the Spiritual First Responders Training Manual. Thank you and God bless you.
Hi, and welcome back to I Believe in Miracles with Dave and Patty Loggy. And we've got Butch and Dave out in North Carolina, and we have Scott Whitley and Mike Politoski out there. We've got Lila in the studio here and Liz. And so it's just got all kinds of stuff. But I wanted to finish telling my story about the baby. You know, it's always a miracle. And, you know, when the baby was here, I waited for a little while. And it's just, I just prayed over the baby and I prayed over the mama and daddy. And they just thanked me so many times after it was done. And it's like, wow, I didn't even know what I was walking into, you know, but I was just being obedient. I was just doing what I knew I was supposed to do. And God blessed me because I've always wanted to see a child be born. And so it was just such a huge blessing. I can't hardly explain to you how cool that is. And I talked to Oscar, he's our adopted dad, and he said, "So are you still on the ceiling?" And I said, "Well, I'm on cloud nine, if that's what you're talking about." "Yes, I sure am." And I said, "I plan on staying there." So I was just so excited afterwards. It just made my day, made my week, made my month. So praise God. And Lila, she had told me, "There's something, Patty, that you're staying here for. There's a reason that you didn't get to go to Florida." And after that, we knew that was part of the reason, huh?
Right.
So it was just amazing how God does these things. So because I didn't go, he blessed me by doing something that I've always wanted to do. And so I just praise God that he had me in the right place at the right time and that I had a joy of being in the middle of that. And so I text the lady that I knew already and I said, "Baby girl," and she's healthy. And everything went well. And she said, "Thank you so much for going." I said, "Oh, thank you so much. It was just a joy for me." So praise God. You never know where you're going to go and what God's going to use you for. But just being obedient, you can just be blessed beyond your imagination. So I just thank God for letting me experience that. So do you guys have any other testimonies over there?
Yeah.
Oh, listen. Now you got Scott. Hi, Scott.
My brother Scott.
All right.
He tells us, you know, where it is in the scripture and what it really means in all the Greek, Hebrew.
Okay. But
he's always got testimonies. And how we met him was he had us come down to do some other teaching to get it in another group. But he shared a testimony of getting somebody off their deathbed. This was one of the coolest ones and how it got us networked with the Down syndrome.
Yeah. Oh, honey, you know, the camera keeps bouncing a lot with all your movement over there and pounding on the table. So welcome, Scott. Tell us.
Any other testimonies? It don't matter.
Yeah. Well, I mean, I can tell that one. I've actually got a... that one and one other one. I'll start off with that one. The first one was we got called to a home on Dial of Palm in Charleston, South Carolina, where a lady had called and said that her husband was sick and she would like for someone to come pray. We didn't know what was going on. We didn't know what the issue was. But when we got there, it turned out that he was in stage 4 bone cancer. It was in his joints and in his organs. He was in it. He had not been eaten. He looked like a skeleton. He had that greenish gray look to his skin that you get right before they go. And when we walked in there, I looked at it and I made that spirit leave him and spoke life into him, took him by the hand, lifted him up out of the bed. He went in there, sat down with us and ate. 3 months later, he was completely healed. There was no cancer anywhere in his body.
Amen.
But one of the things that happened that while we were there that we were not expecting was that they obviously had a little girl later in life. And so she's about 2 years old and was born with Down syndrome. And so before we left, she said, "Well, would you mind praying for my daughter with Down syndrome?" I'd never done that for Down syndrome, but sure. Yeah, that's great. We'll do that. And the little girl, she was very touch-me-not. She did not like anybody to be touching her, but so we just spoke life into her. Within a year, her eyes had turned back oval. Her head had went back to being oval instead of round like a Down syndrome baby. Her ears had shifted down, and God had healed her completely on a DNA level.
Amen.
You know, and, you know, he is faithful no matter what. But the other story that I went through, because I've got... You know, I got a lot of stories of the Lord healing people.
Amen.
And one in particular. Well, no, actually, I got two. I got to tell this other one too. I got called by one of my friends and asked. There was a in MUSC in Charleston, which is the equivalent of Duke University in South Carolina. that there was a young teenager, actually I think he was like 17 or 18 years old. He was in a coma. He was on life support on a ventilator, and they were saying the doctors were trying to talk to the parents and tell them to pull the plug on this young man, and that he would, that even if he lived, he would be a vegetable, and that they needed to go ahead and just let him go. So we were asked to go over and pray for him. And so we went in, and sure enough, he had a trach in his neck and was on a ventilator. And we spoke life to him and, you know, didn't see anything at that very second. And went out, talked with his parents or his mother for a few minutes, and then gave her our information so she could contact us, and left. Well, 6 months later, we still hadn't heard anything about it. And I had not gotten any kind of contact with her. And the same friend that had asked us to come over and talk to pray with him had actually gave me a call, and he was talking. He was talking to me about it like I knew something. And I said, well, what are you talking about? I don't know what you're talking about. And he said, oh, you don't know what happened after you left. I said, no, I don't know what you're talking about. He says, well, the next morning, he had the best day that he's had in a long, long time. He was obeying commands and stuff like that. Now, but still, the doctors were saying he was still going to be just a vegetable. And so they took him off the ventilator for a minute just to kind of prove their point. And he quit breathing for a second. And then he started breathing on his own. And then the next thing you know, he's awake. And now he is completely healed and is linked. Worship with his guitar at his church now.
Oh, wow. Praise God.
Praise God.
That is so cool.
Wow.
And this is the man, that young man that the doctors were saying there is no hope for. He is going to be a vegetable for the rest of his life. You know, don't do it.
They said that about me a couple of times. They told me I was dead, blind, and crippled.
That's right. But the last one is a blessing, and it's also a little heartbreaking for me, because I realized that after it was over with that I didn't listen to the Lord on something. Because this goes to show you just how much the Lord loves people and wants people healed.
Yeah.
I had gone to visit one of my friends just to see how he was, because I'd heard one of his family members was in ICU and was dying. That he was out of his head. He was not eating, and his organs were shutting down. So we're just saying it's just a matter of time. And it was actually his older brother, and he wasn't old. He's probably in his early 50s or something. So he should have never been in that situation. Mm-hmm. So I asked him, you know, would he mind if I went up there and prayed with him? And he said, no, that's fine. So I went in there and marched straight into the ICU. Didn't even ask anybody. I don't know if they thought I was just supposed to be there or not, but I somehow got all the way back there without being questioned. And he was so bad off that they made me put on one of those old yellow gowns, you know, so he could catch something so easily. And I walked in the door. I immediately saw that this was demonic. His head was rolling around on the bed. And when I walked in the room, the moment I stepped in the room, he quit and eyes locked on me.
Oh.
He even though he was looking at me, it wasn't him looking at me.
Right.
And I knew what that was. And so I walked up to him and I told it that and made it leave in Jesus' name. And it left.
Amen.
And tell that he kind of come back at that point a little bit. And the Lord gave me a word for him. I won't go into what he gave, because he don't always give me a word to give people. But in other words, the Lord told me that he would heal him. And I spoke life into him and then left. Now, I knew God just healed him. I walked out. I was just all excited because God done healed this boy. And And even go down to, as I'm leaving, I run into an elderly man who's having trouble walking up the sidewalk, and lay hands on him, and he gets healed. And he's praising God walking up the sidewalk.
Amen.
Well, I'm happy. I'm just proud and pleased with myself because and I get in my vehicle and the Lord said, "You disobeyed me."
Ouch.
And I thought, "Oh, what? Wait a minute." And because I'm thinking, "Oh, wait a minute, you know, there's two healings right there." And he said, "If you would have listened to me," he said, "you would have cleared out the ICU."
Oh.
Ouch.
He said, "I wanted you to, after laying hands on that first one," he said, "I wanted you to go to the next room." And he said, "When you would have walked into the next room and prayed," he said, "other people that were Christians would have followed you and that they would have put their faith along with you." And he said, "And when that one was healed, you would have went to the next one." And he said, "And immediately they would have been healed, and then the next one and the next one." And he said, "And eventually you would have cleaned the entire ICU would have been."
Wow.
But I didn't listen because I was so tickled with what I had already seen that one that I didn't think about the fact is that he wanted all of them healed.
Yeah.
And I, Lord just shook through me. Oh, I shook the camera again. Sorry. Yeah.
Lila's over here with God bumps.
Confirmation, that inward witness is the confirmation.
Yeah.
That's why it looks like I get upset because I see them open doors where it goes pop, 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 pop. Once it starts popping, you could just go clean out a whole hospital.
Right.
And it's somebody always bringing you back down to the mind realm to get you out of that. And they, most of them don't do it on purpose, but they still do it. Once you get that rolling like that, it just pops like popcorn. That's why I'm running down the row of a couple hundred people. And they all get healed no matter what they need.
Amen.
And I'm always trying to stretch it. I'd like to line up 1,000 people. Once it starts popping, it's just like running down a picket fence.
Amen.
That's why we share the testimonies, what we got working and how we got it working better. You know, I was pretty good when I got 35 backs healed in 5 minutes, but we went to Canada, we got 19 healed in one. You know, we're stretching it because something's going to happen. You're going to have to hit the masses. You can't do the old stuff that we used to do with 4 or 5 hours for one person. Come on, Jesus never did that.
Right.
Peter never did it. Paul never, nobody ever did it that way. We got to start doing it the Bible way.
Yes.
Lay down our traditions. And Jesus only healed two ways, either command or laid hands, and it wasn't more than one sentence.
Right. Amen. So did you have another one you wanted to share, Scott?
Well, I will tell you, I'll tell you one last one, because I don't want to hog up everybody's time.
But yeah, a couple minutes till the 22.
You know, one of the things I used to think back years ago that something went right with me because I would have deja vu so strong that I had always been taught that that was witchcraft, that you know, you shouldn't have that stuff. So I would do my dead level best to not have deja vu. As a matter of fact, I would have it so strong sometimes that I would do opposite of what I saw.
Oh.
So that it wouldn't be the same way. Well, one day, my wife's best friend, her fiance, who was a fitness fanatic, in phenomenal shape, and he's my age, all of a sudden had almost a stroke-like symptom. His arm locked up. He couldn't swallow. He couldn't stand on his own. They put him in the hospital, yet they did all the tests, and it says no stroke. They can't figure out what's going on with him. So they put me in, you know, put him in there, and they're running all these tests, and he's terrified. He's not born again. He don't know what's going on. He thinks he's been working out all these years. He should be fine, you know, by the world standard. He's in such great shape. He shouldn't have problems. Mm-hmm. So my friend, my wife's friend asked us, would we come up there and pray for him? You know, well, when I got up there, the first unction of the Holy Spirit I got was I went, wait a minute, does he know that I'm coming? And she said, no, that's a good thing to know before you walk in the room with someone. But the next thing was is that when I got, as I'm walking back toward, and we're walking to the stroke unit, because that's where they got him in a room. And as I'm walking back there, suddenly I have
this deja vu. Yeah, that's the only way I can explain it. Back then, I didn't know that it was prophetic.
I know.
But all of a sudden, I saw almost like a picture. I want you to do this, 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 and this. And this is what he's going to do. When you get in a room, I want you to say this to him and then tell him this. And so I went, okay. And so I went back in there. First thing the Lord told me, he says, I want you to get everybody out of the room except you and him. Now, this man doesn't know me.
I like it better that way.
He has no idea. So here I am going, I want all you family members and everybody. The Lord said, I need to talk to him alone. Can you give me a few minutes? And to their credit, they all left. And so I walked over to him, and he's just looking at me, and I said, here's what the Lord said. He said, you've been running from him, and he said, he's going to heal you. He said, but you know who he is, and it's time for you to come. And he said, yeah, and I led him to the Lord right then.
Amen.
On him, and all of a sudden, all his stuff was, all his symptoms were gone. And to this day, they still don't know what was going on. The doctors still don't know what was the matter with him. Why was it?
Devil got a hold of him.
Break time.
Yeah. Well, hang on. We'll be right back. We're going to take a quick commercial. Thank you, Scott.
From the RE/MAX Real Estate Concept Studios, this is Webcast One Live.
I was hungry. I was thirsty. I was a stranger. I was naked. I was sick. To the least of these, Holy Spirit-led Ministries is a proud supporter of Impact Ministries International, changing the world together. Find out more at tstammen.com.
Hello, I'm Mike Politoski with Praise Broadcasting Network. For the finest in praise and worship music, visit us at www.pbnradio.com. We at PBN are proud supporters of Dave and Patty Loggy, Holy Spirit-led ministries, and we encourage you to prayerfully consider doing the same. You can visit their website at hslm.us and click the donate button and be a part of helping Dave and Patty reaching out to thousands of hurting people all across the United States of America. You know, the Great Commission of Jesus has no boundaries and no borders, and it takes enormous expenses to move a ministry like HSLM across the country. Would you like to be a part of it? We certainly would appreciate it. Join us in supporting Holy Spirit-led ministries by visiting www.hslm.us and click the donate button. Thank you and God bless you.
Hi, welcome back to I Believe in Miracles with Dave and Patty Loggy. And we had Scott Whitley on, and he was just telling the testimony about the guy got healed. And I don't know if you were done with that one or if that was it, Scott.
They got Mike on.
Oh, my brother, okay.
Another brother.
Hi, Mike. How are you? Good to see you.
I'm just doing great, Patty. Good to see you as well. It's been a action-packed couple of days around here.
Praise God. I think that happens wherever Dave goes, and when you are with him, you guys just see all kinds of stuff, don't you?
Yes, we do. We even saw a crocodile. Did they tell you about the crocodile?
Nope. No.
I took a picture of it and put it on Facebook. So we saw crocodiles. We've seen you name it. We've seen it this weekend. So
oh,
it's been
wow.
A lot of fun. But we saw some healings. I'm not sure. I've been in there praying for folks right now. I'm not sure what all miracles that these guys have.
We didn't give them the details of either one of them.
Oh, but we saw miracles. We saw we went to a little town called Homosassa's, Florida. And a young lady there had a condition called RSD, and I don't really know what that stands for. It can't be that very much important because it's only got three letters in it. But she had that condition, and there's pain all over her body. And I began to tell her that this was a spiritual issue, and we were going to prove it to her because all of her pain was going to go away immediately. And she said, okay. So Dave prayed for her probably – oh, it's one of really, really long prayers. I think maybe 10 seconds or so. Really, really long. And all of her skeletal pain, I guess you could call it, the torso pain went away. And then I asked her if she had any other discomfort, and she had a serious burning in the front of her legs. Said it felt like sandpaper, scratchy sandpaper is the way she described it. And I said, okay, let me show you how quick that goes away. And I put my hands on her knees, commanded that to go, and it went away immediately. And I said, okay, anything left? She said, yeah, my wrist hurts a little bit. So Butch, I said, Butch, put your hand on her wrist, and he prayed, and the pain went completely away from that. So after that, did you tell about the husband? Oh, so after that, prayed for her husband. His ankles got healed. His degenerative disc got healed in his back. All that pain went away. And then we sat down and checked the alignment of his legs, and his left leg was a half inch shorter than his right leg. And I got his wife to come over there and command that leg to grow out. And you know what? And she got activated. They got filled with the Holy Spirit. They began speaking in tongues. And then their son came in, sat down at the table. He had an alignment problem. His leg grew out. He was having trouble processing this, and he began to talk to me, and I began to tell him, and we gave him a spiritual first responders manual so that he could learn how to do this, and come to find out that he wasn't walking with Christ. He didn't really have a relationship with Christ, so he gave his heart to Christ right then and there. He'd seen mom and dad get healed. We got him to pray for his dad's ears, and guess what? His ears popped open. He had problems with his ears, and they popped open just like that. The son's ears popped open, is what I'm trying to tell you. He got to see the power of God in action. So it's been a really blessing. We had a kind of a small car. I had to get a gallon of Crisco to carry with us so that I could easily get in and out of the car. Other than that, everything went great. It was great.
You're funny.
Yeah, we went to Miami, walked in. We were there to pray for a listener, one of the listeners from Praise Broadcasting Network, who had just general pain all over his whole body. His son was there, and also his wife was there. This gentleman's wife was there. When we walked in, we first met his son, who had fallen down a flight of stairs. He had a cast on his arm. He was in pain. But even as we walked in, he started feeling the power of God hitting him. And I said, where's your pain? And he said, it's in my arm. I said, well, let me pray for that. So prayed for that, and it went away. That was a five-second prayer. And then Dave threw a Holy Ghost fireball at him and knocked him over on the couch. That was pretty cool. And then we prayed for Jim, who had the pain all over him, and that pain dissipated right there on the spot.
Amen.
Did try to reappear, and we gave him a skill set of how to battle that. So we teach people how to walk in power and how to administer divine healing, but we also give them a skill set of how they can combat this if it tries to come back on them, because the devil will try to put it back on you sometime. You just got to know how to take it off and how to say, no, that's not going to happen.
Amen. Well, I have to tell you why you guys were gone. You know, we had a spiritual first responders healing seminar on Saturday, and Dave is usually the one that teaches it all the time. And so since he wasn't here, we asked James if he would step up to the plate, and I thought, well, I can't make him do all of it. I usually don't help with the teaching. I'll just give testimonies and stuff. I thought, well, I can do this. So I thought, Dave, I thought it was the best one ever. And I decided I'm going to have to help you from now on, because it just went so well. So if you guys haven't already seen it, anybody that's watching, it's on our Facebook. And James Alexander and I did the teaching, and we got way ahead of ourselves. And then we had so many testimonies that we're getting that we got kind of behind, and we had to hurry up and get done at the end. But James got wound for sound. His ears were just like on fire. So it was a great teaching time. And so if you haven't seen it already, check it out on Facebook. And it was good. And we actually went to, at lunchtime, went and prayed for a lady over in Berwick. We'd been trying to connect back and forth with her husband and her. She had cancer, and James started ministering to her at first and was speaking life into her, and I could see the color in her face actually change while he was praying for her. And you could feel the atmosphere just shift in the room. So we're believing for a miracle. We prayed for the husband. He had that rotator cuff problem, and he was moving, and it got better and better and better until all the pain was gone. And so it was just a short time at their house, but God did amazing things. So we're believing she's healed from cancer, and we will keep in contact with her because we want to make sure that that's done in Jesus' name. And we want to tell quickly of, we didn't ask about the names, so we're not going to share the names. We had somebody that came to our house the other night, and they actually fell backwards, hit their head on the cement, and it was really not good. They were bleeding from the forehead, and then they had a great big old egg on their head. And so the wife called the ambulance, went to the hospital, and of course I prayed for them immediately as it happened, and the other people that were in the house did, and Kevin stepped up to the plate and was really helpful, and Liz and Solomon were praying. So anyhow, I went to the hospital with her, and we got in there, and I just kept praying, and the swelling ended up going down, and there was internal bleeding, and you could see it coming into his eye, and it was really scary, because he'd had a stroke before, and so there was extra room in there for that blood to be, and that's not a good thing. And he'd taken medication to thin his blood. Well, that's not a good thing when you need it to clot. And so they gave him some medication. Of course, we prayed. We called, had Dave pray. I had other people praying. And I actually said, I want him better than before he came in. I want him better from that previous stroke. And you know what? The bleeding stopped. And they said he had a break on his clavicle, but then they didn't even make him wear the brace home. And she said that he actually, his baseline where he was before, he was communicating better with the nurse after the fact and laughing. And so we just praise God, and we're believing for even more of a miracle. And so we thank God that we were there to be able to pray for him, and that things just turned right around, and God is good. Well, we need to pray for some things now for people. I don't know who wants to pray there.
Finish that. How many days was he in the hospital?
Probably less than 24 hours. Yeah. We went in at night. It happened at 7. We got to the hospital probably by about 7:30 or 8, and he stayed overnight, and they released him in the afternoon. So he was not even there close to 24 hours. So that was a miracle. It was definitely a miracle that he was released so soon from what happened. That was a miracle.
Amen. That's what you call on-the-job training.
Yes, definitely. Definitely. Well, I have a list of different people that we need to pray for. And so I want to get some of those. And then Lila hadn't hardly said anything. We'll have to let her pray. And then whichever one of you wants to pray over there, go. Then you can finish her up. So I just want to lift up Johnny. She was having a problem earlier. And I know that Brianna... there's things that have gotten better with her, but it kind of goes back and forth. And we want to lift up Liz and Dennis. And we just want to lift up all the ministries that we're associated with, IMI, Kingsway, JGLM, Full Speed Impact, and HSLM. We just want to lift them up that everybody can do the work of the Lord.
What? Spiritual First Responders.
Oh, well, yes, that too. I'm sorry, I missed that one. Of course, that's Mike right there.
Okay. All right, I know you're with us.
Okay. So go ahead, Lila.
Father God, we just lift all these requests up to you, and we know that you are able to do above and beyond anything we ask. And so we just speak to Johnny now, and we say, be healed in the name of Jesus. We speak to Brianna's body. We say, be healed in Jesus' name. And Dennis, we thank you for your total healing from the top of your head to the bottom of your feet in Jesus' name. We lift up all these ministries. We thank you, Lord God, that we're on the front lines to do your work and your will, and we praise your holy name for it.
Amen.
Amen.
Go ahead, guys.
God, I just want to thank you right now. Lord, I thank you right now for the wonderful fellowship we've had and the healings and the miracles that we've seen over the past few days and the past few years. Lord, you are so good to us, and we just thank you so much for it. We thank you for commanding us to go do this and giving us the opportunity and the wherewithal and means to effect your great commission across this world, this entire world. Right now, I just want to speak a word of encouragement to anybody out there who is going through something that they think there's no hope. There are no hopeless cases. Jesus has paid the price for all of your sicknesses and infirmities, and we just take authority over those right now. We command them to go in the name of Jesus. And I'm praying with a friend of ours here in Asheboro who has some pains, some issues from gout. I just want to command all that pain and that sickness to go right now in the name of Jesus. Every bit of it must go. It must bow its knee. And we just declare that that will be so in the name of Jesus. And I thank you for all my friends that are watching this program here. Thank you for your support for HSLM. Remember, this is a worldwide outreach. You see my commercial on here from time to time. You see me giving a vote of confidence from our friends at Praise Broadcasting Network. I just want to encourage you to get on board with HSLM. Even if you're unable to go out and minister healing to people at the moment, we'll at least support a ministry that does. And HSLM would be a good one and a good place to get started. And I just thank God for my friends here and the outreach that they have.
And Mike's too shy to say, but if it wasn't for him, we wouldn't have a manual or teaching. If you don't have one, order one. It just gives the word of God rightly divided. It's simple, easy. You can do it, read it in a day, get activated. Have us coming. Do a whole meeting at your church, your home group, anywhere. Amen. We'll go anywhere. That's why we have the testimonies.
Amen. Yeah, we like to travel. But we'd be happy to come out. The training takes one day, or you can come to Ankeny, or you can come here to North Carolina. You can go out in the streets and minister with us. We can minister in churches. Amen. We'll get you activated, and you will be laying hands on the sick, see them recover.
Yes, and we are actually going to have one this Saturday in Newton, Iowa. It'll be in a home, Liz and Kevin's home, and there's plenty of room for lots of people. So come and get this message. Get trained up so that you can lay hands on the sick and watch them recover. I'm sure you have friends and family, coworkers and neighbors that are sick that really could use you to get this message, because they're not going to come. So they need you to come get this message. So Newton, Iowa, it's on our Facebook. It's on our website. And then we'll be having one in Ankeny in April. We're not sure on the date on that yet. But we'll have another one. We try to have one every month in Ankeny so that we can get more people trained up in this area, and people can come here for wherever. We met Butch from Michigan. He came all the way to get the message. Praise God. And we also want to thank Claudia and Pat from PBN. They helped make this happen with you guys coming out there. We really appreciate all that they've done. And Philip Kiefer, he just sent us a laptop, and it's just Zoom. You'll love it, honey. And Zoe, he's going to do some work for us. And Michael on the website, and also Mackenzie. And then Maddie, who's our producer. We just have so many people. Lila, she's such a blessing. And Liz, she is too. So we just want to thank everybody on the team that works with us, that makes this all happen, because we can't do it by ourselves. So, and we want to thank those supporters that give to the ministry. It's such a blessing. And we're out there every day doing God's work. So we couldn't do it without you. And so I guess I better say goodnight, guys. Our time is up. I'm sorry, but thank you for all being on the show with us.
You're welcome.
Be blessed.
God bless you.
All right. God bless. And most of all, we want to thank God, because God's the one that makes everything happen. He makes everything line up just right. So we couldn't do it without him. the Jesus in us is the one that makes it happen. So we'll see you next week, same time, same place. God bless.
You hold my every moment. You calm my raging sea. You.